We want to match each equation to the correct graph. Notice all the equations are in the form a times b to the power of x, which means they're all exponential functions. And for a quick review, a is called the initial value, meaning the function value when x is equal to 0. So if it's the function value when x equals 0, a would also be the y-intercept of the function. Now the reason it's called the initial value though is often we use the variable t instead of x to represent time. And when t is equal to 0, that would be the starting amount or initial value before the exponential growth or decay starts. If the base is between 0 and 1, we have exponential decay, which means the function would be decreasing, which means from left to right the graph would be going downhill, or it would look something like this. And if b is greater than 1, we have exponential growth, which means the function is increasing, or the function is going uphill from left to right, something like this. Now let's take a look at our equations again. And let's first focus on the value of a, or the initial value. Notice all of these functions have an initial value of 3 except this function here. Since a is equal to 4, this graph would have a y-intercept of positive 4, and because a is greater than 1, it would also be exponential growth. So looking at our graphs, notice that there's only one function that has a y-intercept of positive 4, and notice that it's also exponential growth because it's going uphill from left to right. So the second equation would produce the brown graph. Looking at the four remaining equations, let's see if we can find the two that would represent exponential decay, which means the value of b at the base would be between 0 and 1. Notice the first equation would be exponential decay because b is equal to 0.7, and this equation here because b is equal to 0.5. Notice how the values of a are the same, so they both have a y-intercept of positive 3, but again, they're both exponential decay, so they'd be going downhill from left to right. So looking at our graphs, notice there's only two graphs that represent exponential decay. That would be the blue function here, and the red function here. Notice how the red function is decreasing faster because it's steeper going downhill from left to right, which means the red graph would have a smaller value of b. The closer b is to 0, the faster it would be decreasing, which means the red graph would be the equation with b equal to 0.5, and the blue graph that now looks black, but this blue graph here would be the equation with the b value of 0.7. Again, the smaller value of b, or the closer b is to 0, the faster it would decrease. That leaves us with two other equations to match. We have this equation here, where b is equal to 1.5, and this equation here, where b is equal to 1.2. But notice both equations do have a value of b that's greater than 1, which means that both will be exponential growth. And since a is equal to 3, they also have a y-intercept of positive 3. So now we should focus on the green graph and the black graph. Again, we don't need to be concerned about the brown graph because we know that one has a y-intercept of 4, which we already matched. Notice how the black graph is increasing faster, which means the value of b would be larger than the value of b for the green graph. And since 1.5 is greater than 1.2, this equation here would represent the black graph, and this equation here with b equal 1.2 would be the green graph. I hope this helps explain some of the characteristics of exponential functions.